गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम वैशाखी शाह फ्रॉम एलजे इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी. इन आवर सब्जेक्ट फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स एंड हाइड्रोलिक्स, वी स्टार्टेड आवर न्यू मॉड्यूल और न्यू चैप्टर विच वॉज डायमेंशनल एनालिसिस इन आवर लास्ट लेक्चर. नाउ इन दिस लेक्चर टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी सम बेसिक क्वान्टिटीज और यू कैन से मॉडल एनालिसिस फॉर दिस डायमेंशनल एनालिसिस चैप्टर. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द थ्योरी मॉडल एनालिसिस. Now, what do you mean by first of all the term model? Then you must have to clearly differentiate between two terminologies, where first is model and second is prototype. So first of all, model is the small scale replica of the actual structure or machine. If you know, then if you go on a site and before construction of any site, there is a model in office which is same replica, same image like site, the building constructed on site. So that is a model, which is a small replica, small structure, or which is a copy, you can say a copy or small copy of actual structure, or you can say machine. And on other side, prototype is a actual structure or machine. Prototype is a actual structure or machine. Actual structure is called prototype, or actual construction is called prototype, but the replica, the small scale image, that is called model. So in this topic we are going to study model analysis in detail. So you must be clear between difference between model and prototype. Here you can see that there are two cars here. This car is your prototype and this is your model car. This is your actual car. But before designing any car, any machine or any structure, first we design a small scale replica or small scale copy of that original machine or car. This is your small copy, which is called model car, and this is your actual car, which is your prototype car. So in a prototype car, the length we are considering LP, velocity VP, viscosity mu P, and density rho P, prototype. All terminologies for prototype. But for model, you are considering length of this model LM, velocity VM, viscosity mu M, and density rho M. So this is your prototype car, and same replica of this car, that is your model car. So the model analysis is the experimental technique to finding out solution of complex problem. Before construction or before designing any machine, if you create a model here, you can apply so many experiments on model. Then and then you can apply all the results on your prototype machine. Okay. So as you can see here, there is a dam structure. There are the spillways from which water is passing out. Now this is a model. This is a model of dam structure which is constructed in laboratory. Now all the experiments, velocity, wind force or any other forces are find out on this model before designing any dam structure. After all the criteria are fulfilled by this model, you can apply that criteria on site, and this is the actual image which is your prototype dam. So this is your prototype dam and these are your spillways for the prototype dam. But before construction, you have to do so many research and you have to apply that concept into model. Clear? So there is a difference between model and prototype. Model is a small scale replica and prototype is your original structure or machine. Okay. So now there are different types of model, where there are mainly two types. First is undistorted models and second is distorted models. Now what do you mean by undistorted model? So this model is geometrically similar to its prototype. If any model is geometrically in length or in width or in height similar to its prototype, that is called undistorted model. So the scale ratio of linear dimension of the model and prototype are the same. If you are taking length by width ratio in prototype and if you are taking length by width ratio in model, if two ratios, the value of two ratios are same, then it is called undistorted models. The behavior of the prototype can be easily predicted from the result of this type of model. All the scale ratio are same for model and prototype, that is called undistorted model. Okay, now our second type of model is distorted model. So in distorted model, the model is not geometrically similar to its prototype. Geometrically, if you are taking length by width ratio for model and if you are taking length by width ratio for prototype, they both are not same in value. So that type of model is called distorted models. And here rivers or harbors or reservoirs are the example for distorted models. Okay, now our next theory is similitude, or you can say it is a type of similarities. Similitudes are the types of similarities. Now similar, there are as we know, there are two types, prototype and model. Prototype and model. Now there are so many similarities between prototype and model, so we have to study the similarities or similitude between prototype and model. So there are types of similarity, where first is geometric similarity, second is kinematic similarity, and third is dynamic similarity. So there are mainly three types of similarities are there. As you can see, this is your prototype. Now height of this prototype is L and we are constructed a model here. Height of model we are taking L by 2. So there may be some similarities between this prototype and this models. So we will discuss all these types, all three types of similarity in detail. So let's start with our first similarity, which is called geometric similarity. Now it exists if the ratio of corresponding linear dimension in the model and prototypes are equal. Now linear dimension, as you can see that here is a prototype of car and it is a model of car. Okay, now as you can see here, the length of prototype is L and width of prototype is B. Same way, the length of model here is L and width of model is B. Now if ratio of linear dimension in model and prototype are equal, then it is called geometric similarity. How? So if you are taking a ratio of length of prototype to length of model, length of prototype to length of model, which we indicate as LR, scale ratio. Okay, now secondly, you will take ratio of area of prototype to area of model, AP by AM, which is written as LR into LR, LR square, that is area's ratio. And third, you can say the another ratio we are taking here is VP by VM, volume of prototype to volume of model. So you can say LR into LR into LR, which is LR cube. So that is volumes ratio. Now you can now if this all the ratios are linear, then it is called geometric similarity. Okay, now second type of similarity is kinematic similarity. Now the definition of kinematic similarity, it means a similarity of motion between model and prototype. Similarity in motion between model and prototype. As you can see that here is an image of prototype and here is an image of model. Now in a prototype, you can clearly see the velocity in vertical, which is VA, and velocity horizontal, which is UA. Okay, now for this velocity VA and velocity UA. So if you know the similarity in motion, then it is called kinematic similarity. So you can say that VP1 by VM1, which is a velocity of prototype 1 to velocity of model 1, equals to VR, that is velocity ratio. And second, AP1 by AM1, which is a ratio of acceleration of prototype to acceleration of model, that is AR, which is called acceleration ratio. So this means similarity in motion between model and prototype, that is your kinematic similarity. Now third type of similarity is dynamic similarity. It means a similarity of forces. The forces in prototype and model are similar, then it is called dynamic similarity. As we know, indicate forces with F. So Fi equals to Fip by Fim, force in prototype by force in model, that is your force ratio. Here, as you can see, this is the image of prototype and this is the image of the model. Now, force between prototype and model, if there are similar forces in prototype and model, then that is called dynamic similarity. Clear? So we studied three types of similarity: geometric similarity, kinematic similarity, and third is dynamic similarity. Now our next topic, where as we know that on anything in the world, any body on the world, there are so many forces acting on the body. So as you can see, friction force, gravity force, magnetic force, applied force, buoyant force, tension force, drag force, and spring force. Any of these force is acting on any of the body. But here, particularly for the fluid, there are so many types of forces acting on the fluid. Like spring force is not acting on the fluid. So on the fluid, there are so many types of forces which are acting. So the forces acting on fluid are, where first is inertia force. These are the important forces acting on the fluid. Remember that these forces are acting on fluid. Okay, here we are going to study some forces which are acting on the fluid. Okay, so where first is inertia force, indicate as Fi. The second is viscous force, which is Fv. Third is gravity force, indicate as Fg. Fourth is pressure force, indicate as Fp. Fifth is your surface tension force, indicate as Fs. And sixth is your elastic force, indicate as Fe. Now, these six types of forces are acting on the fluid. And these types of forces we are going to study in detail in our remaining chapter. So, firstly, we will understand these forces first, where first force was inertia force, indicate as Fi. So, inertia force is equals to product of mass and acceleration. Inertia force is a multiplication of product of mass and acceleration of flowing fluid, and it is acting in a direction opposite to the direction of acceleration. It is acting opposite in the direction of acceleration. If you are moving like this, then inertia force is acting opposite to the direction of the flow. Now, second force is viscous force, indicate as Fv. Now, viscous force is equals to product of shear stress due to viscosity and surface area of the liquid. We already studied the viscosity in detail. So, viscous force is a product of shear stress due to viscosity and surface area of the flow. Now, third type of force is gravity force. We indicate gravity force as Fg. Now, it is equal to the product of mass and acceleration. It is the product of mass into mass and acceleration due to gravity of the flowing fluid. Clear? Now, Next is, as we know that F equals to mg. Now next is pressure force. Now force, pressure into area. So here pressure force is equals to product of pressure intensity and cross sectional area. Pressure intensity is P and cross sectional area is A. So pressure into area is a pressure force, indicate as Fp. Now next force is surface tension force. If you remember, then we already studied the theory of surface tension in our chapter called properties of fluid. So surface tension force, it is equals to the product of surface tension, which is sigma, and length of the surface of the flowing fluid. So sigma into L is your surface tension force. Sigma surface tension, and L is a length of the fluid. Now next type of force and last type of force is elastic force, indicate as Fe. So it is equals to the product of elastic stress and area of the flowing fluid. Product of stress, but which stress? Elastic stress to the area of flowing fluid. So these six type of stresses are important in fluid flow, and we are going to study all these types of stresses in detail in our next lecture. So enough for today. In next lecture we will discuss all these type of stresses in detail, and where is the use of all six type of stress, all six types of forces in detail, we will see in our next lecture. Okay, goodbye.